welcome to Have a Cup of Tea and Learn Chinese with me. I'm Cecilia Chen. I am a teacher from Taiwan. And if you're interested in Taiwanese culture or traditional character, definitely subscribe to my channel. I have new video every single week. All right, so today actually I would like to talk about pronunciation with you. Pronunciation. All right, so pronunciation is the most, maybe people consider that it's the most difficult part of learning Chinese language, right? So actually recently I have been receiving a lot of messages talking about, so I'm wondering why I have been learning Chinese for a long time, but my pronunciation is still a big problem and people cannot really understand me. So before explaining you that, I want to share a story with you. So in my classroom, sometimes we have an intermediate student or advanced student join my beginner's class, okay? Because my beginner class offer writing class, okay? Writing Chinese characters. So they want to learn how to write, so they join my class. And I found out one thing. One interesting thing is that those who can pronounce the better Chinese is not always intermediate or advanced level student. And most of the time, those who can pronounce better are the beginner, surprisingly. So what's the problem here? So I found out one thing. For those who already learn Chinese for a long time, of course they know a lot of vocabulary, right? So in the class, I'm teaching the vocabulary, but before I say the vocabulary, and those who already know those vocabulary, they will say, oh, I know, and then say it before me actually pronouncing it. So here's the problem. They are neglecting the correct pronunciation and they are missing the chance of hearing the correct tone or pronunciation. So very important, if you're someone already learned Chinese for a long time but you still find that your pronunciation has some problem, think about that. If you always pronounce the vocabulary as the way you think it should be and neglecting the correct, like maybe from MP3, from CD or your teacher, you just think that you know it, so you pronounce it in your way. Or think about when you're studying by yourself. Do you just look at the book and then look at the Chinese character or the pinyin and pronounce it by yourself without actually playing the CD or MP3 that come with your book? Okay, this can make huge difference. Because if you always say it the way that you think it should be or it's correct, and actually you are missing the chance of fixing your pronunciation because you think you know, but actually not. So very important is to listen. To listen is the key of fixing your pronunciation. And I always tell my student that I much prefer that you know the pronunciation well than knowing a lot of vocabulary. Because even though you know a lot of vocabulary, but if you cannot pronounce them right and people cannot understand you, and those vocabulary is basically nothing because you cannot communicate with people and it doesn't count, right? So very important, today I would like to share my 4 tips for you to fixing your pronunciation. Step number 1, listen. Listen, okay, so I know that you might be rolling your eyeball and saying that, of course I know that I have to listen. Okay, but let me ask you a question. So how many of you actually fully pay attention to your teacher or your MP3 CD, stuff like that? How many of you actually aware when you're listening to the sound? Do you just listen and go, let it go, or you listen and you try to remember the sound? This has huge difference, okay? You need to have conscious when you're listening to something. I know it's very easy that you listen and then you think, okay, I hear it, and then but you still say the way that you think it should be. You need to be aware what you're hearing and try to copy the sound that you heard, okay? So this is the first step, okay? Don't rush to say it before you hear the correct one. Step 2 is to copy and say it. Copy and say it. So after you hearing that the correct sound, you have to say it, okay? While you say it, you also need to have conscious and aware of what you are pronouncing. So this is second step, right? Say it. Third step is that you have to evaluate. Evaluate is super important. So previous two steps, you are already aware what you're saying, what you're hearing, and now you can evaluate if your pronunciation and the MP3 or CD's pronunciation are the same. And then it's not just finished like this. The last part is the most important part. So after that, you know, okay, maybe my tone can be higher. Okay, maybe my tone can be lower. So the last step is to fix it. So modify and say it again. Modify and say it again. Okay, until that you think that, okay, my pronunciation and my CD's pronunciation are exactly the same. So this is how I call the four effective steps for you to improving your pronunciation. Okay, so after explaining you that, let's do a practice, okay? Okay, so let's take 珍珠奶茶, bubble milk tea as example, okay? Right, so first, listen. 珍珠奶茶. Okay, so remember. 珍珠奶茶. Okay, so now you say it. Okay, and then we say it together. 珍珠奶茶. Okay, evaluate. Is your pronunciation and my pronunciation are the same? Okay, and then modify and say it. So again, please. 很好, okay, great. So now you know how to improve your pronunciation by yourself. Take out your textbook for beginner, your first book of learning Chinese. And then you play the CD. Forget about what you learned before because those are the wrong pronunciation. You want to get rid of them. So start from the beginning. Okay, there's never too late to start this, okay? Right, so I really hope that this method will be helpful for you. And try this method. If you think that your pronunciation is getting progress, tag me in your IG story or leave a comment down below. I'd be very, very happy to know that your Chinese pronunciation is getting better. All right, so see you next time. Bye-bye. 再见.